Historians find a maze of secret Nazi tunnels in Austria. The small and sleepy town of St. Georgen und der Gusen in Austria holds some very dark secrets. During World War II, it was home to the Nazi Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp, where thousands upon thousands of Jews were systematically murdered. Nazi death camp survivors cheer on Allied soldiers as the concentration camp of Mauthausen-Gusen is liberated. Thousands of prisoners at this camp were used to construct underground catacombs that made up the B-8 Burgkristall weapons facility in St. Georgen und der Gusen, and possibly an additional facility that was used for research on nuclear fusion, aka creating an atomic bomb. A lone guard tower looks out over the barbed wire fence that still stands at Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp in this haunting image. I can't imagine the horror these people went through every day. It really is unimaginable to think of what could have happened to our world if Hitler had succeeded in developing an atomic bomb. A photo of Mauthausen-Gusen emptied after it was liberated by the Allied powers in May of 1945. Even just this picture gives me the chills. I can't even begin to imagine the feeling of terror that the thousands of people who passed through those gates must have experienced. These secret tunnel openings were made by the Germans as a last-ditch effort to hold on to the secret weapons facility as it became more and more clear that the Allies were going to win the war. They even went as far as sealing entrances with giant granite plates to keep Allied soldiers out even after the war was over. Andreas Sulzer works with excavation crews to break through the secret tunnels built by Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp prisoners. Entrances to the labyrinth of underground tunnels will hopefully reveal never-before-discovered laboratories used to conduct research on atomic weapons by Hitler's team of scientists. Sulzer is intimately involved in the process of discovery and excavation for this project. His interest in finding the site of Hitler's secret atomic research began when he read a letter written by Victor Schauberger that detailed his involvement in secret research involving atom smashing. Sulzer also unearthed some very interesting documents by a top American agent who kept tabs on Nazi scientists. In these documents, this man says there is a major complex hidden underneath St. Georgen. We found these very interesting documents that point out that there was a very secret project going on in St. Georgen. It could also be associated with atomic research, said Sulzer. An authentic Nazi SS helmet found at excavation site. Sulzer and his team of historians and scientists have been digging at this site for 3 years. Can you imagine unearthing a piece of history such as this? Hans Kammler, a higher-ranking Nazi officer, was put in charge of the Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp. He even signed off on the blueprints for every gas chamber that was put into a concentration camp. He also oversaw the work done by prisoners as they built the first jet engine-powered airplane, the Messerschmitt Me-262, in a secret weapons facility known as the B-8 Burgkristall factory. A revolutionary aircraft at the time of its development, it was the fastest aircraft on Earth until the Allies came out with their own jet-powered airplanes. To top it all off, he was also in charge of Hitler's missile program, including the V-2 rocket that was used against London late in the war. In the center of this photo we have SS commander of the Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp, Franz Ziehrs. Slugger and his team believe there may actually be a mass grave hidden somewhere within the catacombs of prisoner-built tunnels. Evidence of this comes from documents and interviews obtained by Sulzer. The most compelling piece of information may come from Franz Ziehrs himself. He was shot while attempting to flee the facility and was interrogated before his death. Franz Ziehrs admitted on his deathbed that he had orders to kill the inmates at the facility, specifically the ones working on secret projects for the Third Reich. He was told to bring them to the tunnels and blow them up with a chemical substance, but he claimed that he did not execute the order, says Sulzer. Even so, estimates are that some 320,000 prisoners perished because of the horrible conditions in the underground catacombs. The scale of this facility is enormous. Tunnels run on for acres, 75 acres to be exact. Ground-penetrating radar was needed to assess the size of the massive facility. The existence of this facility was highly valued by the Third Reich. So much so that the head of the SS, Heinrich Himmler, visited the site throughout the war. The Nazis considered it one of their most valued secrets and went to great lengths to keep it hidden from the opposing forces. Sulzer and his crew had to use heavy machinery to break through the concrete and granite seals the Nazis put in place to keep people out. These dark, cramped tunnels were once home to weapons development and possibly even atomic bomb research. Thousands upon thousands of concentration camp prisoners died building these underground tunnels. Prisoners with specific skills such as physicists, chemists, and rocket experts were brought in for their knowledge and used to try to help develop these weapons of mass destruction. The exact location of this maze of tunnels was found using ground-penetrating radar and by conducting radiation-level tests around the town of St. Georgen and Der Gusen. These tunnels may hold the bodies of thousands of Jews that were killed days before the Allied liberation of the Mauthausen-Gusen concentration camp. Workers from the concentration camp built these tunnels deep underground to protect the facilities from Allied bombing runs that decimated Europe near the end of the war. Thank you for watching this fantastic story. Please tap one of the two videos on your screen for another amazing Wonder Stories.